The Ondes Martenot is one of the very first synthesizers, and I want to own one. Unfortunately, you can't really buy them online, they're kinda obscure and rare, so I'm thinking it'd be a fun challenge to build one. In this first episode, I want to test how the instrument actually makes sound, because it doesn't just generate a sine wave, but it actually generates two very high frequency waves, which then when added together sort of cancel out but not quite and end up making a wave that is audible in the human range. I have an analog discovery device which can be used to create sine waves, so I'm going to begin with just a control test, something on the human spectrum, and just see if that actually generates a sound. As you can tell, it's working. The AD2 actually has two oscillators, meaning that I can do something like this. However, I'm fairly certain the oscillators are both connected to a mutual ground, so I can't connect them in series like that, so I'm gonna have to be a bit more clever. However, I think I can connect them like this, with ground in the middle. I'm gonna test it without the speaker first. And that's exactly what I wanted to see. The combination of short waves creates a large wave, which is perceptible over time, as in increase and decrease in volume. Despite the fact that I only used oscillations of hundreds of cycles per second, you can hear a very clear one cycle per second increase and decrease in volume due to the phases lining up and then cancelling each other out. In theory, all I need to do is increase the frequencies of the original voltage sources, and then the difference in those frequencies will be heard as the pitch itself. And it does work, but it's extremely quiet. I had to double the input voltage in order for it to be audible. If I were to increase the input voltage, then it would be louder. However, I'm already reaching the limit of how much power the speaker can take. However, it does work, and I'm happy about that. I'm not sure whether to stick to the original method of sound production, or whether I should just simply generate the wave that the human will be able to hear in the first place.